Oh, look at this. Oh, way out. And Forza was in no time of going to walk. Again, quick with Uncle Sam here. Doing the government early with Al Gore. Looks like he's going to get Uncle Sam as well. Going to get a huge pink slip. That's what I'm talking about. Uncle Sam did. Going to receive that pink slip. And then Forza making a huge statement on the U.S. government here tonight. That's what I'm talking about. I mean, I don't care if you're the U.S. government, I don't care if you're the Queen of England, I don't care who you are, you'll come in our house and try to take things over. That's what I'm telling you. That's why you come in our house, bitch. Forced to make a quick look with Uncle Sam here. I'm sure to some people, it's definitely a controversial moment indeed. What happened to involving Uncle Sam and the Enforcer? In my opinion, this is definitely a defining Kangolian moment for sure. Oh, wait a minute! My God, that's that pink slip. That wasn't enough for Uncle Sam. If they could come back with the Enforcer here. Oh, look at this. Oh, look at these triple German suplexes on the Enforcer. Oh, my God, Uncle Sam. Kicking out Nick Willis here. And you don't think that was Uncle Sam who came in the limo early here tonight. Oh, no, not this. American Slam on the Enforcer Nick Willis. I mean, it all makes sense now. How did Uncle Sam in that limousine earlier? Oh, wait a minute! Wait, look at this! It's Luke Fallon, Ross River, and Mitchell! UW Originals coming to the aid of the Enforcer. The three best friends here from high school. Going to town on Uncle Sam here. Going to Sam talking about the FCC trying to get involved in UWA. You know, even the Enforcer, that's not going to intimidate the Enforcer one bit. Oh, look at that. It's going to hit Uncle Sam with that chair. I don't know why Uncle Sam is here in the UWA or what's his business, but obviously Enforcer not allowing him to make his presence felt here tonight. That's the last thing we want here in the UWA. You know, Uncle Sam said he was UW management. Now that he has sole ownership, he's fired UW management. Oh! So I was ripping out Uncle Sam head first in that chair. Now the Enforcer has sole ownership of the UWA. He has now has the right to fire and get rid of UWA management. It's all this time. Uncle Sam, according to what he said earlier, Filmo and Regina hired Uncle Sam to be part of UWA, head of UWA management. And these three men is going to continue their assault on the Uncle Sam here. Oh! Forcer going with an elbow.
You're telling me the same UWA management, Uncle Sam, the same person behind such rulings as there's no security clause here in the UWA? We take another replay of Uncle Sam actually getting pwned, rightfully so here. This is all that time was Uncle Sam, my God, I can't believe it. But now the Enforcer's taking sole control. You know, he did the right thing and fired the last remaining member. Look at Uncle Sam! What the fuck is wrong with the Enforcer doing? Oh my God!
This sit him his ass down with that face buster. And you might as well just call that move just call it simply sit down, because that's exactly what he did to the Uncle Sam. His first to sit his ass down with that face buster. And Ross Mitchell going 503 on his ass. Goodness, these three is all oh no, he's gonna drop that sock down his throat. God, there's three people that don't give a crap about the government thinks of the UWA. It's definitely the UWA Originals. Luke Fowler, Ross Mitchell, and the Enforcer Nick Willis. Luke Fowler going high risk. You know, this is going to be the flying aces here. Oh, look at that. His dead center targeted is Uncle Sam. Goodness, I'm serious. Look at these three individuals here, the movers and shakers of the UWA. Making a statement here tonight, a defining moment indeed. If there's one company that's persevered through the best of times and worst of times in the last 10 years, it's the UWA, like other big Fortune 500 companies. The UWA has never had to ask for a bailout or, you know, a hand up from the U.S. government. So the pride and honor that these men and women have in the UWA is a bubble is better than any wrestling promotion out there. Of course, time to move on here. Time for that huge defining moment involving the Enforcer and Uncle Sam. Up next, we're going to have the fight to the bitter end as Gucci Wolf and Gorman and Mitch Watson and the Fuzz Bunny can take on the Suicidals and Sombriado of the Cool Coalition. The fight to the bitter end and the losing team must leave the UWA for good.
What the hell's this?
What's this about?
Wait a minute.
Who's this interrupting
I've
here?
I've seen that man before. He's back. Talk about tainting the pandemonium moment. Wait a minute. Oh, no, not this damn move. Let that go to sleep. Regin von Killingsworth returns in the most shocking manner ever.
Like that.
Wait a minute. Randy Axe is still here. What the hell's he doing here? Oh, my goodness. That's a sick clothesline. Effort, this man came out on top here and now holds the contract that will seal his destiny at Pandemonium. The bitter end.
The following contest is a fight to the bitter end. Will be contested is a Hell in a Cell on their way to the ring. From Houston, Texas, he is the chosen one, Mitch Larson. From Battleground, Washington, he's the world's greatest warrior, incoming. They are fighters by nature.
And even in that video package, this soft said that we'll be facing the turn on steel cage match. I think it's safe to say that Gunther Wolf, the enforcer, who changed the stipulation here at the last second and making this a Hell in a Cell match. And how fitting is it to be in a Hell in a Cell match instead of a steel cage match? I mean, this, not only is Hell in a Cell a career-threatening, structure, because I'm perfect match, it's like we talk about every death match, really here to the World Class Tag Team, that's perfectly changed. Tonight, this match here will definitely end the rivalry, the almost the one-year rivalry between the factions, Cards by Nature, and the Pure Coalition. So it seems like it's a fight to the bitter end, it's one match that always seems to end any feud or rivalry at all in the history of WWE.
Now introducing their partner, representing Fighters by Nature, from Frankfurt, Germany, weighing in at 249 pounds, the One Man Massacre, Günther Wolf.
I promise you one thing, folks, this match here is going to be brutal, it's going to be mind-boggling, you know, it's going to be violent, it's going to be disgusting, it's going to be downright awesome, it's just going to be epic. This match is going to be just the epic of matches you've ever seen. And here comes Günther Wolf, who of course made this match when he won Money in the Bank for a one-way ticket.